So this is my new piano. It is a 1912 Steinway A. This piano was kind of brought back from the dead over the past few months by an amazing group of technicians that work at Aardvark Pianos in Boston. George Crawford is the main guy there, and a woman named Angela DeRosa redid the action for me. As you can see by opening the lid, this is what the piano used to look like. This is the mahogany finish, and this is what a lot of it looks like now due to too much sun exposure. I couldn't really afford to redo the finishing on the piano. That would have been several thousand more dollars of work, and I don't really care what the piano looks like as long as it sounds good. I had new strings put in the piano and new pins, but before they did any of that, what they had to do is take the old strings and pins off and take off the plate, which is this metal frame here that sits in the piano. Take off the plate, and they had to repair the soundboard. The soundboard already had some repairs, I think, were done in the 70s. As you see this, there was a crack in the soundboard you see running across here, and this is a shim that was put in, and it looks like there were even some, maybe some screws put in to hold the two sides apart from each other. So what George does in the shop is he actually dries out the soundboard to try to bring the cracks out, so that we sort of know what the maximum damage is possible on this piano. And then he puts the, actually saws down the crack and puts a new shim in and seals everything back up. There was also a little bit of cracking on the sides of the bridge, but you can't really see them, and he glued those back up. Underneath the metal plate here, these pins sit in a wooden pin block, and we were hoping to be able to keep the pin block, but when we took the plate off, George found a lot of water damage. There was actually, someone must have spilled some water in there at some point. And so he had to build a new pin block to put in the piano. When Angela was working on the action, she found a lot of mouse nibblings and mouse poop inside the piano, so obviously there had been mice in there at some point. In the mid-70s, when they redid the piano a little bit then, they replaced the tops of the hammers. But other than that, all of the action is the original action, and we didn't have to replace anything, which is amazing considering the condition the piano was in. The sides of the keys had mold on them, and Angela actually sanded down the sides of the keys to get all the mold off. And the key tops are not ivory anymore, they're plastic, and there was a lot of yellow discoloring, but she did a great job polishing the keys. The action needed a lot of work to get it consistent, but now it's super springy and feels great. So I'm really pleased with all the work she did on the action. And now I have this awesome, fully functioning, totally amazing Steinway A that I now own.